Now with AMD's RX 6000 GPUs, Nvidia's RTX 3000 series finally have some competition. But do they really? I'm going to tell you which GPUs are really the ones that you should be looking to get and the reasons why. Let's get started. Hey guys, Tiago here. So AMD versus Nvidia. This is starting a whole new competitive level at the higher end with these GPUs. Of course, we can expect more and more mid-tier and lower-end GPUs to come out next year, but for now, we have a pretty heavy dose of high-end competition. Now, I personally think there's a pretty clear-cut winner so far, and we're gonna analyze this based on three different metrics. First is gonna be stock and availability, second is gonna be the performance, and then third is gonna be the price. So the scope of this video, we'll be talking about pretty much the following GPUs. On the Nvidia side, and this is almost like a heavyweight boxing match, we have the RTX 3070, 3080, and 3090. On AMD side, we're going to have the 6800 and the 6800 XT, and of course, we're going to talk about the Founders Edition, reference models, and the third-party AIB custom GPUs from both manufacturers. So first, let's tackle stock and availability. For sure, this is going to be the most important aspect when you're really purchasing your GPU now. It even seems to take precedence over the performance and price in many cases. It seems like if you can find the GPU, that seems to be like the one you go for, especially if you walk into a store and you see it on the shelf, or if you happen to refresh Newegg or something like that. So stock and availability certainly is going to be a pretty big consideration. So let's talk about Nvidia versus AMD stock and availability. To be fair, Nvidia did release their GPUs first, so they've had a little bit more time on the market to restock and to be able to take a look at what's going on. But AMD was also watching from the sidelines this entire time and could have made a little bit better game plan. So for the first stock and availability category, I really think Nvidia is trouncing AMD here. Now, it may not seem so because even us, we've complained about the really limited launch of the RTX 3080. When it came out, that really opened all the floodgates for like really low availability, for really high demand. But in retrospect, those launches really don't seem anywhere near as bad as the AMD launch was. So sometimes we need something worse to put into perspective what we thought was bad, and something that we thought was a pretty lackluster launch with the RTX 3080 over time has proven to potentially not be as bad. So here are a few data points for me to support this argument. First, the RTX 3080, yes, on the initial launch, it seemed to be almost as bad as the 6800 and 6800 XT reference GPU launches from AMD. Certainly was very, very limited. But when the RTX 3070 launched, I think most people will agree, and even my own viewers, they've posted on different polls that I've conducted, a lot more people were able to get the 3070 than were able to get the 3080 and even the 6800. Now, even stores like Micro Center seem to have between 100 to 200 GPUs in stock for people that were going in, as opposed to the RTX 3080 and 6800, which pretty much seem to have maybe at most like 10 to 15 per store, if that. Not to mention the 6800 XT, which was in even more limited numbers. So if we look at the timeline of the Nvidia launch, 3080 and 3090 initially were very, very limited. The 3070 certainly improved, and we have to remember Nvidia released pretty much at the same time not only their reference Founders Edition GPUs, the ones with sort of the iconic design that you guys see with that pass-through cooler, they also released the third-party AIB cards, and those pretty much were available to a greater extent even than the Founders Edition. Now, this is important to note because AMD did a different launch. They did sort of a staggered launch. On November 18th, they released just sort of the 6800 and 6800 XT reference model GPUs, which pretty much come from AMD, and they all pretty much look the same with the exact same cooler. Now, a week later, on the 25th, supposedly was when the AIB or third-party GPUs for AMD was supposed to be released, but as we saw, not only was this launch limited because there was absolutely zero stock. Even Micro Center had to post a community post the night before saying they were going to get zero of the AIB GPUs. If we're using Micro Center as a benchmark here, and I know it's not available in every state and every country, I'm just using it as a benchmark as a store that actually does typically get a lot of stock of these type of GPUs. Because what I found out in the past, if they're getting a lot of stock, typically that means that online like Best Buy and Newegg are also getting stock. If they're getting nothing, usually that means it's going to be a very limited launch once again. And for example, even on the November 18th launch, it seemed like on average, maybe like 10 6800s per store, 6800 XT, maybe 2 to 4 at most. So then you put that together with having absolutely zero AIB partner cards the following week, we can see how the Nvidia launch actually seems pretty good in comparison. Now, don't get me wrong, the demand is absolutely high on both ends. The Nvidia launch was still very limited. They definitely make some mistakes, but as time went on, Nvidia certainly has been replenishing stock of all of the GPUs, 3080, 3090, and 3070. Now, maybe you're still having a hard time getting one, and I certainly agree with you. You can't just walk into a store or check online and every single time you're going to be able to find stock. But if you guys check, various stores have been restocking over time. In fact, even EVGA's queue system for the 3080 has been sending out emails. I got one myself for a GPU that I signed up for previously. Even during the Zen 3 launch, I walked into a micro center and they got a pretty nicely sized shipment of RTX 3080s, 3090s, and 3070s. So they're definitely replenishing. Of course, it's not up to the level where it's going to be on the shelves, but if you catch it on the right day, even Newegg and Best Buy, countless amongst you, even my viewers, have gotten these GPUs. Of course, I'm not saying there's readily available stock at all. I'm just saying they've been pretty much replenishing it a decent amount. Like even on Black Friday, a lot of microcenter stores had a pretty decent shipment of RTX 3000 series GPUs. Of course, the AMD GPUs, if they had them, much, much less, but in most cases, they didn't even have them. So as you can see, even though the Nvidia launch was still troubled and very limited, they did exceedingly better than AMD's launch. Now let's talk about performance. Aside from basing your decision on sort of what's available, what's in stock, how about the performance of most of these Nvidia GPUs versus AMD? Now, this is where I think Nvidia still will win out, even if stock was equal, even if you take that into consideration. Now, let's take a huge game like Cyberpunk 2077. If you want to play it sort of with all the eye candy with ray tracing, definitely, it looks like that the Nvidia GPUs will be your best choice here. Of course, they seem to recommend the 3070 down the line, but anything above that, a 3080, 3090, will be absolutely awesome to be able to play a game like this. Of course, Cyberpunk 2077 probably is a lot more optimized for Nvidia, but still, AMD in general doesn't have that great ray tracing. They're a little bit behind when compared to Nvidia, and considering how great that DLSS and ray tracing and those type of technologies that Nvidia has been pushing for a few years, not to mention all of their other sort of streaming technologies and encoding for professionals, Nvidia certainly still has a pretty sizable lead in those areas versus AMD. Of course, where AMD has caught up more is in traditional rasterization and traditional frames per second performance in games without considering ray tracing and things like that. So pretty much in straight down the middle performance. Certainly, AMD does have a competitive product in that regard. They do, especially with the 6800 XT, often trade blows with the 3080 in many games. In some cases, it can even get pretty close to a 3090, which is certainly pretty crazy in certain respects. Of course, it does have that smart access memory if you pair it with a Ryzen 5000 CPU. But in general, I think when we take a look at everything with the price as well as the availability, and if we include all of these areas that Nvidia certainly has a lead in, including ray tracing, DLSS, not to mention traditionally the Nvidia drivers, we all have to admit are better optimized for games, as AMD certainly has had a few more long-term problems with their drivers in the past. So when we take those elements into consideration, we see that I think something that's going to be more stable and probably provide a lot better gaming experience in general is going to be the RTX 3000 series. Now, for now, we do have three different ones to choose from. The 3070 and 3080, I think, are going to be probably the most popular GPUs that people are looking to get. Of course, the 3090 is pretty cool, but it is priced a little bit too high, I think, for the performance premium. But I think, especially the 3080, AMD really is going to have a hard time toppling that GPU. I never thought that the 6800 was a very compelling choice here, just because the 6800 XT for the MSRP of $80 more does seem to outperform it considerably all across the board. It's a whole different level of GPU. And of course, the 3070 is a good deal cheaper, $80 less, as we're going to talk about in our last and final category, and that's going to be the price of these GPUs. Now, the baseline here, right off the bat, I think it's fair to say everybody was pretty happy with the MSRP of the Nvidia RTX 3000 series. $699 for the 3080 seemed like a pretty ridiculous price to performance, considering how amazing that GPU was performing compared to the previous generation. 3070, $499, has the same performance as a $1,200 2080 Ti from last generation, even if we take into consideration the AIB or the third-party partner models of the RTX 3000 series GPUs. We're talking about Asus, MSI, EVGA. The price premium that you get on top of the Founders Edition really seems to be more or less fair. For example, if an MSRP of $699 is for the Founders Edition 3080, you can find easily a $750 third-party GPU, maybe something like an MSI Ventus or PNY Accelerate or something like that. AMD, and I think this is where they really dropped the ball here, the AIB partner cards, aside from not being available at all, MSRP, pretty ridiculous, taking a 6800 XT, which was supposed to be $649, and for that, it's certainly a very good value, even compared to the 3080, all the way up to as much as $900 for certain GPUs. Now, this seems to go even above a lot of the very high-performing 3080s. It seems like the premium for the AIB partner cards that they have over AMD's own reference pricing MSRP, especially the 6800, a lot of those GPUs are going well into the 600s, even $700 range. So if you compare a 6800 to a 3080, there really is no comparison in terms of performance. Nvidia will beat it any day of the week. Of course, the 6800 XT is a lot more competitive, but when they start going over $800 and when they start becoming considerably more expensive than the RTX 3080, that's where I think the value proposition really isn't there. And here's where I think Nvidia is actually another clear winner. I think these AIB from AMD are just priced way too high. The Nvidia ones, of course, always have a premium, but if you look at the numbers, I think the Nvidia premiums are more what we're used to expecting. And in a lot of cases, performance, especially the 3080, will beat out even the 6800 XT, especially when it comes to things like ray tracing and things that really up the gaming experience to the next level. So in summary, I really think 3070, 3080 is really where most people should be looking. That seems to be overall the best bang for your buck. Hopefully AMD will improve not only their launches, but also their ray tracing, as well as their pricing on some of these GPUs. Alright guys, so let me know if you have any questions down below. Remember to subscribe, a lot more content like this coming up. Smash that like button, and I'll see you guys on the next video.